Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to change the Shopsmith over for a Dado head to cut a quarter inch wide slot for the mirrors to go in. The materials are kept in this great toolbox that's labeled Shopsmith Tools. What you're going to need to do a Dado cut is you're going to need the Dado kit, the blades, and you're going to need the arbor right here. Now, the standard table saw has a gap that's about a quarter of an inch or slightly wider. For the cut we're going to do today, that's fine. If we're going to do a wider cut, you would change out the slot with this. And it's pretty simple. It's got two screws. You take two screws off and you drop this in place. Because we're going to do a thin one, that's not going to be required. Set up for the dado, you're going to need the two largest wrenches in the rack. These are used to change the tool out. Okay?
Okay.
So you're going to come over here. And you're going to need the T-handle to put the arbor on. We've got the arbor out of the box.
What's an arbor?
An arbor is a device that's used to hold a saw blade.
Oh, okay.
It goes on here with the screw up. All right? And it tightens down. Now it's mounted. This head assembly can go back or forth. We're not using the bandsaw, but the operation that we're going to do is going to be localized to here. So I can leave the bandsaw connected. You don't have to lift it off and remove it. If we were doing a big sheet of plywood or something, we might have to remove it. So since this is okay, we're going to turn this and lock the head down in this position so it's not going anywhere. Do not ever.
That was the point to it, the bottom one?
This bottom one,
okay.
Here, yeah. This one is to control this, and we're not doing a drilling motion.
Okay.
So, I mean, it doesn't matter. It's spring loaded. If you want to, you can lock it down.
Okay.
See, now it can't move.
Right.
All right. Do not ever, ever attempt to change the blades on this if it's plugged in.
Okay.
If this switch ever malfunctioned, it would start turning, and if your hands were on the blade, you can imagine. I always have the plug sitting up on top when I do this. It's just a safety thing I do. I know now that it's unplugged. There's no way, and even then I'll do this to make sure that I know that it's on. To get a quarter of an inch hole is fairly easy. It's simply two of these. So lift these two cutter teeth out. We're not going to be using them. And all we're going to need are these two. All right, take them out. You can drop these back in position here. You'll have to figure out how they go in. They stack a certain way, and we'll videotape that in just a minute. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to remove this nut right here, and there's an additional washer. This washer is a special washer. It has a little tooth on it, and that tooth fits into a slot on here, and that's so that as we tighten it up, it doesn't spin. Okay? So now the arbor has the basic piece and it has these two clamp units. If we were doing a thick cut with a lot of blades, we would just put the one clamp unit on there. But because we're doing a thin cut, we put this one in as well.
Oh, okay.
So then it's just a simple matter of put the first one on, teeth face this way. Put the second one on, again, teeth face this way. And you might have to fiddle with them to get them, you know, offset them slightly so that they fit together snug. Put this plate on there. And then take this special washer, put it on there, and put the nut on here. And here's where the two tools come in handy. You've got two wrenches. The largest of the two fits here. The next one fits over here. You hold this one in place and turn this one. And now it's locked. Don't lean over it in such a way that if you slipped, you would go like this because you'll cut yourself. Just go like this, and it doesn't have to be super tight. Just enough to snug them down so it doesn't spin. At that point, you can take these off. This is now ready to go. With the power still off, we're next going to adjust the table. And the table adjustment for this is very easy. There's two knobs down here. This knob, when it's loosened up, allows the table to go up and down. We're going to go as high as the table can go. like this. And then we're going to temporarily lock it in place. So now the table's way up here. We're going to loosen this one up a couple of turns, and sometimes you have to kind of go like that to break it loose. And we're going to slide it so that the slot is over the blade. Then we're going to loosen this, and we're going to drop the blade down, and we're going to make sure that it's not going to hit on anything. If we need to, we could adjust this left or right so that it doesn't hit. And you see we got a little bit of clearance on each side. That's what we want. Now we lock this down. At that point, we adjust the height of the blade. So now we want to adjust the depth, and obviously this is way too high. Okay? So we come down here to this knob, and we raise the table up. And we get it to where the crown of the tooth just touches. See how it's just starting to lift the gauge up? See it?
Yeah, yeah.
We get it to where the thing is just sitting on there. And then we turn this to lock it into place. So now the blade is adjusted at exactly 3/8 of an inch. So if we pass this across, it's going to make 3/8 of an inch cut. Yeah. Underneath of here, you'll see that there's a pin. If we loosen this up by turning this, this thing can move.
Okay.
All right. If we put this pin in and we go like this, it hits. See how it stops?
Uh-huh.
That's 90 degrees. Then just snug that down.
Okay.
And that's typically where I leave this. So it should be set at a good solid 90 degrees.
Okay.
All right. To set a 15 degree angle, make sure this pin is in the out position. Loosen this up by turning it counterclockwise. All right. You have a veneer gauge right here. It says 0 degrees. Slide it to where the 15 degrees, and actually we're going to have a problem. See, it's binding on the blade up here.
Mm-hmm.
So I need to raise the table up because we're going to do an unusual angle. We've got to set this for 15 degrees. So it's got to go in to where the 15 degree mark, which is right there,
yeah,
is sitting on the zero veneer. That's 15 degrees. Actually, I think we said 10 degrees. I think we did it for 10. So I'm going to set it with the 10 degree mark lined up to the veneer there.
You think you did 10?
Yeah, yeah, 15.
Okay,
I think it's too
much.
Okay. All right, so now that's snugged down.
Okay.
Now what we need to do is we need to drop this table down. And if you notice, it's now crashing on here.
Yeah.
So I need to loosen this knob.
It's not that much.
Jiggle it around and then slide this over a hair so that this drops down and make sure that it clears. It's not touching a saw blade.
Okay.
All right, now I can snug this down. After doing that, I need to get my gauge right here. Find the one that says 3/8 of an inch, which is right here. And I need to set it up for a 3/8 inch slot.
Oh, so you angle this thing on that. Okay.
Now that it's set for a 3/8 inch slot depth, I snug this down. All right. So now this is tight and this is tight. This is tight. So it's not going to move here. The angle's not going to change. It's not going to go up and down. And the blade is set properly.
Yeah, it's not too hard.
To get the angle right, I have to do it this way.
Oh, the angle's wrong? Is the angle
yeah,
right?
Yeah, the angle was wrong.
The angle was wrong.
Yeah. That's when this thing's up. Yeah. So. That's why it ended up being a little more than half of an inch. Because, see, this is right up against there, half of an inch.
Oh, yeah.
But where the cut is will be slightly further away.
Oh, okay. That's fine.
All right. So now.
So the angle's right now?
The angle's right. The fence is right. We're going to be taking a board, basically, and we're going to be sliding this board across here, making a cut.
Right.
You can see that the board could slip.
Yeah.
Which would mess things up.
Right. So you've got your little handy little.
This is a feather board. And the way a feather board works is it only allows the wood to travel in one direction. Obviously, if I put it this way, it would allow the wood to go this way, which is wrong.
Uh-huh.
So what we need to do is take these two screws off, flip this over, and put these back on like this.
So I it's going to be like that, so I don't have to do that, right?
Right, well, I'm just showing you in case I do a project and I leave it the wrong way. So now what you do is put the board in.
Oh, because it pushes
the
it.
The feather board goes just in front of the saw blade, where like the first couple teeth are lined up with the blade.
Okay.
All right. You put this in and you apply a little bit of pressure. See the feathers starting to move?
Yeah.
Then lock it down. So that now as I push, this thing will keep the board pushed up against there.
Okay.
So that when I'm cutting the piece, I only have to concentrate on two things. Holding it down with this tool,
right,
and pushing it with this tool.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
At that point in time, we should be good.
Okay.